Sustainability is a pretty hot buzzword at this day and age, and it probably conjures up different images for all of you, from recycling to solar panels to taking shorter showers. Sustainability is an important concept when we think about the use of our resources, and in particular, our non-renewable fossil resources, like oil and natural gas. Many of the products that we use every single day, like shampoo or ballpoint pens, have components in them that are derived from these non-renewable sources. A lot of those components can't be made from renewable sources, and so for now, we are relegated to using non-renewable resources to make these chemicals. So that's where my work comes in. If we truly are relegated to using non-renewable sources, then it's in our best interest as a society to find the most efficient and environmentally friendly ways to use those resources. Propylene oxide is a chemical that's used to make a lot of industrial and consumer goods. For example, it's found in automobile interiors, cosmetics manufacturing, food-safe plastics, and airplane de-icing fluid, just to name a few of the applications for this chemical. It's derived from fossil resources that are non-renewable, and it's one of those chemicals I mentioned earlier that we can't really make from renewable sources right now. However, we can strive to make it more sustainably than we do currently. The chemical transformation itself looks pretty straightforward on paper. You take propylene, which is a 3-carbon molecule that comes from natural gas or oil, and you take oxygen and add it, which is an abundant molecule in our atmosphere. In practice, however, controlling the chemical reaction to get the product that you want is not so trivial. This is seen with the chemical industry processes that are used to make it, that generate lots of wastewater, use lots of energy, and use expensive reactants. So for such a small and simple transformation, there must be a better way, right? Well, that better way is found through the use of catalysts, which lower the energy required for a chemical reaction to take place. This results in less wastewater, fewer byproducts, and lower energy usage, all of which contribute to a more sustainable process. I've been using a silver nanoparticle catalyst to transform propylene and oxygen into propylene oxide. By understanding how fast the reaction takes place and how the reaction responds to different conditions, I obtain information on how to improve that catalyst and further increase the productivity and the sustainability of the reaction. With an industrially viable and sustainable method for making this really important chemical, we can reduce the amount of waste generated and the amount of energy used in the manufacture of everyday products, like car seats or lipstick, and we provide a sustainable chemical solution to the protection of our resources for the future. Thank you.